Well, everyone, this is Lucas, and today I'm bringing you, I think it's part three or part four, one of the two, of how to build your own bicycle house. And today I'm going to discuss briefly what I'm doing here in regards to my design and condensation. So originally I designed to put a plywood deck on this, but I live in a micro enclosure, and one of your biggest problems in a micro enclosure in the winter, especially if you're going to deal with things like heating fuels like butane or LPG or whatever it is that you're dealing with, alcohol, they all produce water vapor, and you yourself as well produce water vapor, so that in turn leads to condensation. Now, I decided to go against a wooden deck in favor of a metal one, and in this case I got some old shelving units, and these are old shelves, and as you can see, they already have slitted holes in them. And the idea is that this isn't going to be the entire floor, and that I'm actually going to put styrofoam on my floor in order to insulate me first from the cold and this steel decking. And what I'm going to be doing is that as I develop the walls for the size of my tiny house, I'm going to leave a gap. And I'm going to leave a gap on purpose so that as the condensation is produced in the tiny house, it will be allowed to flow under the styrofoam and onto the metal decking and then drain out the bottom. And I'm convinced that this will work, because on days, I am going to pick up ice, don't get me wrong, this is going to ice up here from time to time, but I'm convinced that this metal decking in conjunction with the styrofoam and a little bit of a spacer material is actually going to allow the condensation to drip out of the bottom of the tiny house, okay, after it goes through its cycle, collecting on the walls and all this other kind of stuff. Now, this is also the last video I'm going to do of the tiny house. I'm not going to do another one. I don't want you guys to know what this looks like. Half of the fun of owning something like this is having something that you can take anywhere, drop anywhere, and kind of get away with sleeping wherever you want at night, which is my idea and something I want to continue on doing. It's something that I enjoyed doing in the camper, is the whole stealth camping aspect of the invention itself. All I'm doing right now is I'm going around and I'm drilling screw holes in the frame, and I'm mounting this. I had to cut all these by hand with a angle grinder and a cutoff blade, so not everything is exactly square, but I'm going to zip over top of it again with a flapper disc, and then I'm going to repaint it all black, the same as the rest of the frame and all that other kind of stuff. But again, I'm not going to show you what you're doing with the walls and all that kind of stuff. The walls are going to be made out of some thin recycled, this is underlay, it's very thin plywood. Going to be using some thin plywood for the walls, with some styrofoam and some spray foam. I'm going to cut it all down, and then I'm going to find some way to plasticize it so that the condensation, again, like I said, if you make sure a dome over top of this, kind of sort of, the condensation is going to stick to the dome, it's going to run down the sides, and it's going to be allowed to go underneath it. Now, I'm actually counting on the condensation to create a seal in the gaps that I make, so that yes, they are going to ice up, but if I get the Bachmann hot enough, that it will all drip out down the bottom. That's the theory. Okay, I don't know if it's going to work. In next videos that I show, I will be inside the Bachmann, not the outside. So I will show you the inside of how I get things to work once I get them working, but I'm not going to show people what this looks like on the outside. I'm going to make it look really nice. If you happen to see it when you drive by, fine, but I'm not going to show people what my house looks like on YouTube. I think that was half the mistake that I made in my video with the camper and why I got stalked by, you know, the EPS and all this stuff. But as long as this one has lights and a slow vehicle sign on it, and I'm not under some kind of power vehicle pulling it, they pretty much can't say anything, I don't think. They can ask me to move, but I think that's about it. As long as it meets all the requirements for a bicycle trailer, there's not really much they can do about it. So I hope. So again, there's that, and then there's the hope on the condensation. But I'm pretty sure I've lived in, like, you know, a camper during the winter, micro enclosures, other things that I've made. I've experimented with a lot of insulation materials, building materials, and all this kind of stuff. So I kind of know what happens with condensation in the winter, and I'm convinced that this is going to get rid of it. So if you like this video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And if you're building your own bicycle camper, man, post a link down below in the comments, because I really want to see that. Okay, take care. Next video, we'll be inside.